morning friends, I am Suraj Agrawal and you are watching your favorite YouTube channel Gardening is my Passion. Today friends, I am going to show you some of the important tips how to grow GERBERA in this summer season. So these are basically some of the winter flowers in our Indian country, so Indian climate or Asian climate, some of the tropical countries. These are the flowers of GERBERA daisy. These are GERBERA, these are the origin of Africa, Asia and some part of Europe. These are native to Africa, Asia and some part of the Europe. And these are the scientific name is GERBERA jamesoni and GERBERA viridifolia. So these are the all hybrids of GERBERA jamesoni and GERBERA viridifolia. These are the GERBERA hybrida. So this comes in varieties of colors, yellow from pink to red, and different colors in orange and different colors, lots of colors. And you see, this is the capitulum. This is not the flower. This consists hundreds of flowers altogether. This is called capitulum. It comes in two leaves and these are the hundreds of flowers are there. This is some family from Asteraceae family. So flower. So this capitulum flowers, it comes with a single stalk, long stalk, around 12 inches stalk flower. And these are the flowers, single flower with beautiful florets. And this basically, these are grown as a garden flower plant and some of the cut flowers. These are basically the most beautiful cut flowers on earth. These are the GERBERA. So these are the all tropical climates, though they are tropical climate plants, but they don't like much of the direct sunlight. We have to grow them with much care because these are very costly plant. In India, these are cost around 100 rupees, that cost around $2 per each plant. So these are very costly plant. I tell you, this is some perennial plant. Some places where the much of the frost come in the winter months, they grow it as an annual plant. But in our countries, that those are tropical countries, these are mid-range of temperature, they grow it as a perennial plant. So once you grow these plants, you can take flowers from year after year, you can take flowers from there. So keep on watching. I am giving you some important tips how to grow these GERBERA plants in the summer months. So tip number one, so grow them under shade. These in Calcutta now temperature is around 25 to 37 degrees centigrade, and these plants cannot tolerate such kind of high temperature. They should grow between 10 degrees centigrade to 25 degrees centigrade. So we have to keep it under shade or such a place where temperature doesn't rise, and you have to keep it shade. As we have grown here, all the plants we have kept in under shade. So friends, point number two, supply them with 3 to 4 hours morning sunlight. So you have to give them enough sunlight, morning sunlight, 3 to 4 hours. Don't expose them in direct and noon time of sunlight. So you have to give them morning sunlight and afternoon sunlight you have to give them. If you keep them in some of the windows there, so that you place them in a plant in such a way that they can get only the morning sunlight, not the noon time of sunlight. So friends, point number three, for watering. So these are the plants, you don't water the plants from the above the crown. Don't grab that. Give the plants the long spouted some water server and just give it at the base of the plant. You just water it, and if you are keeping it in your room, just water it every 3 days. Don't water it much, and whenever you feel this the above side is half inch is dried totally, then only you water it. Otherwise, don't water it much. If the soil gets soggy, the plant may die and that will get all the fungal problem. And if you water it from the above sides and from above, they will attack all the fungal. These are the fungal attack. If you water it from the above crown side, all the leaves will be attacked by the fungal and rot problem with the mildew problem. So they will kill the plants. So don't water from above the crown, water it at the base of the soil. So friends, point number four, cut back the dead and damaged foliage. This is the some damaged foliage, some dead, so that the plant health can be maintained. Just cut off all the dead foliage and leaves, and just if the flower is pent up, just remove all the stalked flower so that new bloom can come out from here. So you have to throw away this type of dead and foliage so that these plants can be maintained in very good health and new sprouts will come out from here. So friends, point number five, don't try to repot the plants much. So once you have potted the plant, don't try to report it much, because once you have trouble reporting it, the roots all may get damaged. So they don't like much of the reporting. So once you get it here, and while reporting, you must add some of the little bit of compost, vermicompost or cow dung compost. Don't mix much of the fertilizer or manure here, and the plants doesn't like much of the manure. So friends, point number six, sometimes the plants get attacked by the aphids and mites. Usually they do not get attacked with many of the insects and flies and all. So sometimes they get attacked by the aphids and mites. Just spray insecticidal soap, just spray the insecticide soap, and all the aphids and mites will get killed. So don't spray any of the chemical insecticide. Don't try to use much of the chemical insecticides. Only using the insecticidal soap will be enough for giving killing all the aphids and mites here. So friends, point number seven, this is the most important point. So whenever you are growing any kind of gerbera, any variety, any cultivar of gerbera, there are thousands of cultivars around the globe, all the kind of gerbera. So you have to keep in mind that you use the soil, very, very oil-drained soil. Gerbera plants do not like at all, they cannot tolerate any kind of sogginess, any kind of water in their roots. So whenever you are planting the plants, just use some of the sand or some of the husk or some of the mulching here, so that the water can quickly get out from these pots and cans. So these are all the important tips, and just have a look, some of the beautiful gerbera we have grown in some winter months, and have a look.
Gerbera daisies comes in a variety of color, textures and forms. It is hard to beat the flowers today's hybrid gerbera disease. Excellent. They come in colors of yellow, orange, red, pink, and blend of colors, a variety of blending of colors. The flowers are large and long lasting on the plants and as they cut flowers. The gerbera disease can be house plants or annual garden plants, anywhere you can grow. This can be fabulous flower for coming. Pay attention, light, temperature and fertilizer is the main important point for growing this gerbera.
So hope you have enjoyed the video, you have understood some of the few of the points of maintaining the gerbera plants, and if you at all have liked the video, please give it a like, give it a thumbs up, and if you want to share with your near and dear ones, with your friends and relatives, please share with your near and dear ones. And if you are very new to my channel, if you want to subscribe my channel, please subscribe my channel. I am going to give you lots and lots of flowering care and tips and tricks of all the flowering and non-flowering and foliage plants and all the vegetable gardens and all. So thank you very much. Keep on watching. Thank you. So nice of you.